What's going on, guys? It's Divine, and today we're going to be covering mining in New World. Now, this is a skill I feel cannot be missed by anyone because of how essential it becomes for most crafting items, and you also have to have some sort of mining for the quests as well. So let's waste no time and jump right in. So first up, we're actually going to be covering strength, which is an attribute, but it can also affect your mining skills. So as of this breakdown, we can actually see that starting right off at level 50, you're going to gain a 10% mining speed increase. Then at 100, you're actually going to get the ability to hold 20 more weight. And then moving on to 150, you will actually get a 10% weight reduction for mined items, which is actually pretty nice. And then at 200, you're going to get your second increase of mining speed, again, getting another 10%. And then at 250, you're going to get a 10% yield in items mined, which can be very beneficial, especially for some of these ores that only have like one node that you can mine. And then lastly, at 300, you're going to get an awesome bonus of having a 25% chance to mine an item in a single swing, which is just crazy because you could probably knock out some, you know, a lot of nodes really quickly. But with strength, you do get a nice amount of bonuses if you're doing a lot of mining. All right, so moving right along, what I'm going to do is bring up a list of all the tools that we're going to be using. And you can see from this list that we have five different options. But one thing to note on this list is the gathering speed. This can actually increase depending on the gear score of the items. So I put the lowest you can expect to see on the item, but this could always be higher. So just be aware of that. So we can see our first option is actually going to be a flint pickaxe. Now, I would recommend you guys, as long as you're on that starting beach area doing those quests, make the pickaxe there. You do actually get one later on when you move into the city and you're given one through a quest, but honestly, you could miss out on a lot of nodes along the way in between that time frame that you might kick yourself for not having the pickaxe earlier. And then moving on, you have the iron pickaxe, which is going to be starting at level 5 to equip. I would recommend trying to find one of these as soon as possible. And then you move on to the steel pickaxe, and then you can actually see that giant increase between 125% and 250. That is very beneficial, guys. So if you can get into steel pretty early on, I would recommend it. And then you have the star metal pickaxe and the auric calcum pickaxe, which are also very, very good options to upgrade as soon as you can. But I would really focus early on trying to get the steel items if you can. They're a pretty good all-around set, so I think you'd be pretty comfortable having just those if that's all you could find for a while before you can get the materials for the really high stuff. And along the lines for upgrading all your tools and things like that, just note that once you start getting to like steel and up, you do have to worry about the crafting station level itself. So things like steel, you're actually going to need a level 3 crafting station to create that pickaxe. So just note that early on, maybe these cities are not going to have those tier 3, you know, stations that you need to be able to craft these items, and you might have to look to other towns to be able to create those. Alright, so continuing on, now we're actually going to go over tool perks. Now, if you've seen my harvesting guide, this is probably going to look pretty similar because most of the tool perks do similar things. So, up first we have the Sliver of Adamant, which is going to increase the durability on your tools. Next is the Azoth Extraction. Now, when on mining equipment, I feel like this is a less useful of a perk rather than like gathering tools, but this will actually grant you an ability to get one Azoth per node. And then moving on, we have Mining Luck, which will give you between 2 and 9% for finding a rare item while mining, which can be pretty beneficial since mining will give you gems, it'll give you some other cool rare items, so getting a lot of luck on your mining gear can be really nice. Alright, so then we're moving on into Mining Yield, which I feel is a very important perk because of two reasons. First is early game, when everyone is low level, finding ore is going to be pretty hard, and getting as much as possible will be vital, so this can help with that. And then secondly is going to be the like ores like Auric Calcum don't really have a lot of spawn points, and getting the most you can each time it comes up can be a huge time saver. So moving on, we have Prospector's Discipline, which will give you more XP in mining, which can be, again, a very helpful perk early on to get those mining levels up. You know, that way you can start mining star metal and lodestone, things like that. And then lastly, we have Gathering Alacrity, which is going to actually give you that 3 seconds of 50% haste after gathering a node, which I don't feel is that important, but I know some of you guys do like it, especially if you're rushing against other people that are mining different nodes right in your area. It can be a little bit of kind of beneficial, you know, to get that extra speed to the next node. So let's continue right on, and we're going to move right into gear that can give you actually more bonuses while mining. So here we have the full miner equipment set. Now, in my previous video about harvesting, a lot of you were wondering how to get this set. So the first and main way will be to craft this item. But the second way, and I have yet to see it personally drop, is going to be gaining these items from different drops of mobs. From some of the database websites that I've been looking at, they are showing that some of these drops can come from, you know, like alligators or ancients, and it says the level is going to range between 19 and 38. But just note that I have never seen any of these drops yet. They could be really, really rare, or they might not drop at all. I don't know. But I do know that making them is going to be a lot easier and more consistent to be able to have it. So to make this gear, you're actually going to need a shard of Adderstone. So one thing to note with this is there are 5 pieces of the gear. So you have the shirt, pants, gloves, boots, and hat, and they're all going to each require a shard of Adderstone to create this. So it could take a while to get the full set. I would recommend, if you do have a piece, just make a piece here and there. If you're having troubles finding these shards, local trading posts are probably going to be a best bet, but that will come at a premium. So just kind of be aware of that. So up next, we actually have the amulet bonus, which will require a chunk of cobalt to create, but this can actually give you a 5 to 9% chance to finding rare items. So if you're stacking this with the armor, you can really boost up your luck while mining, and you have a better chance to finding like gems and things like that. Okay, so the last piece of gear that you can actually wear and we're going to go over is going to be bag perks, which can go onto the bags that you hold in your inventory. Now, there are 3 perks that can be very useful while mining. And the first one is going to be Prospector's Burden, which requires a sliver of cobalt to make, but will grant you a weight reduction of ingots, ores, and pickaxes between 5 and 10%. Your second option is going to be the Quarryman's Burden, which requires the steel jewel crafting charm. And again, this can reduce weight of stone blocks, gems, pickaxes between that 5 and 10%. And then lastly, we have extra pockets, which is going to need that sliver of Adderstone again, but this will actually grant you an additional 50 to 95 more weight to hold in your inventory. So that is it for the gear that you can actually wear on your character that will affect mining. So up next, I wanted to check out the 3 different mining trophies that you can put into your house. So first up, we have the Mire Mining Trophy, which is going to increase your luck by 500 points. Then we have the Basic Mining Trophy, which ups that to 1,000 points. And then lastly, we have the Major Mining Trophy, which will increase your luck by 1,500 points. Now, you can see under each of these items, I put what is required to create them. And we can see that the Basic and Major are probably going to take a good chunk of time to find the materials to craft these. So just be aware of that. And then on a side note for trophies, I do want to let you guys know that these are global buffs, so you don't need to be in the same territory where your house is to receive these mining boosts to your luck. Alright, so up next we're actually going to start going over some more temporary benefits that we can have to boost our luck while we're mining. And the best kind of thing is probably going to be food. So the main ingredient for the foods that are going to boost the mining luck is going to be potato-based dishes. So we can see up first is going to be roasted potatoes granting 1,000 luck and lasting 20 minutes. Now next is going to be herb roasted potatoes that are going to give you 1,400 points to the luck, and the duration ups by 5 minutes to 25. Then we have boiled potatoes coming in at 1,700 points and lasting 30 minutes. Then we have poultry with roasted potatoes coming in with 1,900 points and lasting 35 minutes. And lastly, we have salted roasted vegetables, which grant 2,000 points and last a total of 40 minutes. So you do have quite a bit of different options to choose from and different tier levels to make them under. So just be aware the higher end ones do take a lot of ingredients to make. So, but I mean, they do last longer and give you more luck. All right, so another temporary boost that can really help you out is going to be proficiency boosters. Now, I did cover these in my harvesting guide, but they're just as effective for mining. And what these will do is actually grant you an increased amount of items gathered by 5 to 15%, depending on the duration of the potions. So these can be really beneficial to mine a lot of nodes and get a lot of ore out of them. I would recommend, they are pretty easy to make. So if you can early on, just start utilizing them. Don't let them sit in your bank. Don't try to just throw them on the ground. Just use them while you're out and about gathering. All right, so now that we understand all the gear that we need while we're out mining and what kind of benefits it can really help us with, what I want to do is take a look at the list here, and I have broken it down for what kind of things you can mine, what level you can gather them at, what level they're tracked at, and then I also put a respawn time on here. Now, note that this respawn time might not be completely perfect, but it is close enough to get you, you know, a good understanding of how long you should be waiting around for these nodes to respawn. All right, so that's really all I have for you guys today, and hopefully you found this guide useful. Now, if you like this video, think about leaving a nice thumbs up, and if you haven't already subscribed, think about hitting that button because it really does help out my channel, and I will catch you guys in the next video.